Welcome back to Mornings at ANC. Small and medium enterprises, or SMEs, are believed to be the backbone of the Philippine economy and the largest job generator. Today, SMEs are enjoying opportunities for growth like never before.
Now, this week, business owners and professionals will have the possibility to explore new business opportunities, establish networks, and learn the latest market trends in a three-day expo.
For more on the Philippine SME Business Expo 2013, we're joined by Mediacom Solutions Incorporated CEO David Abrinilla, Esquire International Finance Incorporated President and CEO Raj Uttamchandani, and Janet Toral, familiar face, author of Blogging from Home, DigitalFilipino.com.
And in this corner over here, Ron, we're also joined by three exhibitors, Jacinto Enlirio co-founder Noreen Bautista, OIC of King James Processed Meat Vanessa Labuga, and Macy Lazaro of Chelsea Leather Goods. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Okay, we'll start with the with our friends here on the couch. Let's start with David. There is a rapid growth in SMEs, and I can imagine that you're not having a difficult time in convincing people to put up their own businesses.
Well, actually, we're not in there to convince people to put up businesses. If people want to put up businesses, that's the time when they approach us.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's what the expo is actually all about. Mm. If you're an entrepreneur and you want to know about how to start a business, if you want to get the right partners into it, that's when they come to the expo. Or if you're already an existing business and you want to grow it, find synergies, strategical partners, then that's the time also you can come to our expo. So we have people like Esquire Financing,
right,
that gives financing solutions for mm-hmm. companies that are in their growth stage. We have great seminars. We have great speakers like Janet,
mm-hmm.
who's going to tell about more about e-commerce businesses, because that's a big step as well. We want to promote innovation, technology. So, yeah.
Okay. For those people who want to borrow money, we have to talk to Raj. No, Raj, why is your company supporting this
actually,
expo?
We're not just supporting the expo, but we support the SME space in general.
Of course, yes.
There's over a million registered businesses in the Philippines, and the DTI classifies, I think, 890,000 as MSMEs.
Mm-hmm.
So micro, small, medium enterprises. And these enterprises contribute to 70% of the workforce, but only 30% of GDP. You know, we've all been hearing about the Philippine growth story mm-hmm. and how the Philippines are growing. Really, this new growth is going to come from the SME sector.
Mm-hmm.
And what Esquire does is we provide a financial solution. So financing plus consultancy to be able to grow your business.
But both of you would see that there is, one, the growing interest and the more people who would want to consult with your businesses.
Yeah.
And so you have a grasp of that growing interest of people in putting up their businesses in SMEs, in moving to SMEs. Has there been a lot more people asking about putting up businesses?
Yeah.
I'll actually take that. I think there is a growing interest on entrepreneurship as people need more and more for their families. And as crisis is striking throughout the financial markets of the world, a lot of overseas foreign workers are now coming home and putting
up their own
businesses. Mm-hmm. And that's why there's a large interest in putting up their own businesses. One of the programs we have is a sales partner program, which allows entrepreneurs to be able to put up their own businesses with Esquire as a partner.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Janet Toral, of course, is going to be a speaker in this event. Give us a teaser of what you'll be talking about, Janet.
Basically, I'll be talking about digital entrepreneurship. And mm-hmm. it's all about the mindset of a digital entrepreneur and how can they compete using e-commerce. And I think the challenge now is that you now have a lot of SMEs who would like to embrace doing things online, but somehow their main challenge is that how can they extend their existing business model to online? What usually mm-hmm. works mm-hmm. offline will not necessarily work online. It requires a re-evaluation of how you're going to do your business.
Mm-hmm.
And some people also, when they embrace digital, it's like looking at it just from a perspective of, I just want to make quick money, or I just want to make an immediate revenue within a short term, rather than looking at it, hooking it to their passion, and appreciating what are the necessary components to make a digital business work, and hitting an ultimate goal so that you don't get easily swayed by setbacks and suddenly you don't want to do it anymore. And by having a clearer vision of how they want to do their online business and appreciating the, if you want to say, 360 degrees component of it, then more or less technology, everything else will follow, in a sense that you will decide on what technology can help you rather than choosing on technology first and everything else adjusts.
Are there any major problems in going online, as you mentioned, expanding your business and going digital?
Because a lot of people look at the technology component right away without really reevaluating their business model if it's going to work online. So as a result, if they encounter, let's say they immediately try jump on a social network and try advertising, sell coupons or sell promos, and then they get disappointed because they're not getting the results that they want. And maybe because they immediately just focus on technology rather than really understanding the market and what the cost, what the market needs are for those who are online, and at the same time, the kind of partners that they need to work with. Because the partners that you might have in the offline world would not necessarily be the right partners for the online world to make these things work. So that's where we... That's where the session would be focusing on. It's really more of reevaluating on how you're going to do your business online.
Very interesting. Okay, David Janis is just one of the speakers. Who else are going to be participating in the event and becoming being the speakers for the event?
Yeah, we have a great lineup actually for everybody. We have Randall Chungson, who's going to talk about personal finance. He's a great author and also a columnist at The Enquirer. We have Wilson Lee Flores, who's going to teach or who's going to explain how the tycoons do it, so how SMEs can follow the big guys. He's a columnist at the Philippine Star. We have also Chinky Tan, who's going to talk about how to create wealth. We have Judah Paolo, a former athlete and also actor. He's going to talk about the importance of value in the company, and many, many more. We also have Ralph Wunsch, from MetroDeal, who's going to talk also a little bit about e-commerce and a little bit about his story, how he started. So yeah, it's going to be a great lineup. It's going to be from Friday till Sunday. So all the thing that people just have to do is to drop by. We're open from 10 o'clock until 8 p.m.
Okay, David, just one more. I believe you're going to have a push for social entrepreneurship for this expo. Is that
correct? Exactly. We have great social entrepreneurs where we have one here. So we also invite a lot of social entrepreneurs because we see a big demand in there as well, especially in like community works and how business can also help the communities.
Okay, let's go to Paolo now with our friends there in the other part of the studio. Paolo?
Good stuff, Ron. Now we've had an overview, I guess, of the expo. Now we really want to sort of chat with the people who are going to be part of the expo. I'm going to go from this side all the way to that side over here and start with Noreen over here. Products from Jacinto and Lirio, tell us about your line and how you guys are going to be participating in the expo.
Right. Well, we've been here before. So Jacinto and Lirio was really about helping community livelihoods with the water hyacinth. And right now, actually, more than just the water hyacinth, our direction is to help more on the manufacturing side. So we're actually investing a lot in communities who also do the bag manufacturing and journal manufacturing.
And it's a real good fit in this particular expo because the theme or one of the big things that they're going to be focusing on really is social entrepreneurship.
Yes, true.
And that's obviously what your business has been based on. What sort of products are you guys coming up with that's sort of new and keeping up with what's going on now?
Right. Well, we had just developed our iPad covers actually.
So pretty sharp. I like it.
Yeah, we have gadget sleeves and iPad covers just for the tech generation, of course.
Right.
And definitely we're also working with custom gifts for corporations. So they also have a lot of social sustainability for their advocacies when they have corporate gifts.
Okay.
So that's one direction we're going to now.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm going to chat over here with Vanessa. Tell us about the meat products that you have over here, Vanessa.
Yes, these are family business. Yes, and then we started as homemade, and then now we have a plant in Cavite.
Okay, I think that's sort of the story of many of the people maybe who will be attending the expo, people who have started sort of very small, we're talking SME, and moving on to the next step and really wondering how they can take it up to the next step. How any tips for people who will be wanting to take that next big step?
For people who want to take that big step, so you just don't give up. There are some times that your business will be even break even, but you should not stop. You should really pursue it because in the later years, you will really find out that, wow, it's really worth it.
Right. Okay.
Worth it.
How did this business all start for you guys? I mean, you said it was sort of a small family owned business,
yes.
And you've sort of grown into much. It looks much more professionalized sort of product line that you have here. What sort of a range of products have you got?
Okay, we have here the El Paborito cheesy meaty footlong, mm-hmm. and then we have your tocino,
yeah.
Suacto tocino, and then also the Suacto sweet piña ham, mm-hmm. and then the Suacto smoked longaniza, and also we have the El Paborito smoked bacon, and also we have a cheese dog and the hot dog, and our new product is the cheesy luncheon meat.
Right.
It tastes like
luncheon meat with cheese.
Luncheon meat with cheese. I will not name a brand. Okay. So, yeah.
But you gotta try it, I suppose. Okay, yeah. but like you said, really, I mean, it's expos like these really which will help people sort of take that next big step. I
yes.
mean, people who want to go from a much yeah. sort of a mom and pop sort of
yes.
operation and take it up to the next level. Because this is very professionally packed
so
over here. It's looking pretty good. Let's chat
Thank
with
you.
Macy Lazar over here, who's going to be telling us about their line of products. Macy?
Hi, we're Chelsea Leather Shop. Mm-hmm. This is our new brand, Tannery. This is a premium line. This is the premium leather bag line mm-hmm. of leather bags and accessories.
I love the smell that's coming from the corner.
Thank you.
I love the smell
of
leather.
Yes.
Okay, tell us about the products that you have and how, you know, your business has, you know, the progression of your business.
Actually, it's a family-run business,
mm-hmm.
and we started out as a leather maker. We're actually a tannery.
Right.
We put a lot of effort in making lots of leather, mm-hmm. Premium leather.
Right. This is beautiful. These are beautiful bags, really. I mean, what sort of a market are you guys aiming for, and how does participating in an expo like this sort of help your business along?
Actually, you want to target people who are passionate for
mm-hmm.
travel
mm-hmm.
and passionate leather enthusiasts.
Right.
People who appreciate quality
mm-hmm.
and who see it when they see it.
Right. Who recognize the quality. But I was really wanting to sort of pinpoint, you know, for people who are interested in this sort of a field, how will coming to the expo sort of tie this all together for them?
I'm sorry, again?
What's the benefit of people coming to the expo and checking out your wares? How will you sort of synergize with all these people?
I'm sure these people will see a lot of things and they will discover new ideas
mm-hmm.
that can, of course, help them in their daily lives.
Okay, really cool. Well, I'd like to say thank you to all three of you ladies for joining us this morning, really. Let's head back to Ron. Do you have anything for us, Ron?
Thanks, Paolo. Okay, David, this is going to be held starting this Friday. Why don't you go ahead and invite everyone?
Okay, hello everybody. I would like to invite you all to join the Philippine SME Business Expo this coming July 12th till 14th at the SM Aura. Yeah, that's going to be in the SMX on the third floor. So I'll invite you all on July 12th to 14th. And admission is absolutely for free.
It's free.
Plus, we got a big surprise. We're going to be raffling out the car, which is going to be...
Actually, we're raffling off a Hyundai i10. And it's care of one of my partner companies, buyacar.ph.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's run by one of my business partners, Steve Borsuk. And we're raffling off, you know, he's been kind enough to say we're going to raffle off a car completely
wow.
for free.
Okay, so
yeah.
you can get in for free, listen to Janet Randall, Wilson Lee Flores, and Chiquitan, among others.
And many more.
And have a chance to win a car. Very convincing. A lot of us will be going. Thank you very much to our guests, David, Raj, and Janet. Thank you
very much, Ron.
Let's go back to Warren now for a stock market update.